In this video, I will still be talking about the simultaneous delay equation, but this time it's not that direct and no equations are given to you. You have to form the equation yourself. Okay, let's look at the first one. The diagram shows a rhombus with a parameter of 32 centimeters. Find the value of x and y. So we have two variables here. We need two equations to help us to get the value for x and y. So what are the properties of rhombus? Still remember, right? All the sides same length, right? And this side is parallel to this side. And these two sides are parallel to each other. Okay, so another one which is very important for rhombus, they are diagonal by a set each other, and here will be 90 degrees. But this is not important for this question. Okay. Now, so how do we form two equations? The diagram shows rhombus with a parameter of 32. Parameter of 32. So how do we get the parameters of this diagram? Here, plus here, and plus here, right? So what's the length here? 4x minus 3y plus 7, right? So what's the length here? 2x plus y. Centimeters. So given by the question is a parameter 32, so we can form an equation. Length here plus length here is actually 2 times 4x minus 3y plus 7, right? Because we have 1, 2. That's why I multiply 2. Plus, same thing here, I have to multiply 2 because I have 2x plus y. Here is another 2x plus y. So 2x plus y. This will be equal to 32. So now if I do some expansions, I bring the 2 go in. So it will be 8x minus 6y. Okay, so I think I do this way will be easier. Since here I have 2, 2, and 32, their common factors are 2, right? So I just divide the whole equation by 2. It will be easier. So this one divided by 2, this one divided by 2. This is considered as one term. So we only divide for one time. We cannot take this one divided by 2, 4x divided by 2, the negative 2y divided by 2, and 7 divided by 2. This is not correct. This whole thing considered as one term, so we only divide one time. So it actually become 4x minus 3y plus 7. Plus, here will become 2x plus y. So the bracket here, you can just ignore because this is positive. You put a bracket here. Okay, you keep the bracket. Later on, when you open up the bracket, you still get the same thing. Don't forget here you have to divide it by 2 also. So you can try 16. And now open out the bracket, you'll see exactly the same thing, right? Plus 7 plus 2x plus y equal to 16. Okay, now we try to simplify it. 4x plus 2x, you get 6x. Negative 3y plus y. Let me check again. Okay, so you will get negative 2y. And here 16. Okay, don't forget here we have a positive 7. So you bring the positive 7 over here, become minus 7. So you have 6x minus 2y equal to 9. Okay, let this one be the first equation. We still need another equation. So since this is a rhombus, you know every side are same length. So this must be equal to this. 4x minus 3y plus 7 is equal to 2x plus y. Okay, now I try to rearrange all the terms nicely. 4x positive 2x, it become, bring over here, it become negative 2x. Copy the negative 3y. Positive y become negative y. Equal. The positive 7, I bring it over here. Negative 7. Okay, Okay, so 4x minus 2x, you get 2x. Here you get negative 4y is equal to negative 7. This one be the second equation. So in this question, I think I will just use elimination method. So I just multiply the whole equation here, the second equation, by 3. Why? Because I want to eliminate the x. This is 6, this is 2, right? So in order, if I want to eliminate the x, I have to change their coefficient and become the same first. So I just take the second equation times 3. So you get 6x. Minus, this is, you have to multiply 3 also. Okay, become the third equation. Okay, why do I choose to eliminate the x? Because actually you can choose to eliminate the y also, you will still get the same answer. Okay, so now at this one, I'm holding a copy over here, so easier for me to solve it. 6x minus 2y equal to 9. This is the first equation. So now I can eliminate the x. I take the third one, the third equation, minus the first equation. 6x minus 6x, we get 0x. So the x has been eliminated. Okay, negative 12y minus negative 2y. This actually means negative 12y plus 2y. Negative 10y. Negative 21 minus 9, you get negative 30. So y is equal to negative 30 divided by negative 10. Okay, so y is equal to 3. Okay, so the next step, substitute y equal to 3. It's the number 9 equation, so I cannot circle it. Y equal to 3 into which one is all up to you. You can choose first one, second one, and third one. Okay, I think I just choose the second one. Second equation, 2x minus 4y. Okay, y, I know this is 3, I write 3. Equal to negative 7. 2x minus 12 equal to negative 7. 2x equal to negative 7 plus 12. 2x equal to 5. X equal to 5. Divided by 2, x equal to 2.5. Okay, these are the final answers for these questions. Let's go to the second one. The sum of two numbers is 64. If 5 is subtracted from each number, the bigger number becomes twice a smaller number. What is the difference between these two numbers? So we are looking for the difference between these two numbers. So we actually need to find the true number first. Okay, let the true number be x and y. Okay, so we assume this one is a small number, smaller, and this one is a bigger number. Okay, so now we need to form the two equations ourselves. The sum of two numbers, x plus y, is equal to 64. This is the first equation. Second equation, if 5 is subtracted from each number, 5 is subtracted from x, then it will become x minus 5. So if 5 is subtracted from y, it becomes y minus 5. Okay, let's focus on the second sentence here. When 5 is subtracted from each number, the bigger number becomes twice the small number. So this, since this is a bigger number, this is bigger number, y is a bigger number, so this will become twice of this. So means that here I have 2 times 2. Okay, so now I just do some expansion here, bring the 2 go in, you get 2x minus 10 equal to y minus 5. Okay, so 2x, I keep it over here, positive y, bring over here, negative y. Negative 5, copy first, negative 5. Negative 10, it becomes positive 10. Okay, 2x minus y equal to 5. Okay, now you have the second equation. Okay, right, let me write 2 equations over here. X plus y equal to 64. First equation, 2x minus y equal to 5. Second equation. Okay, now I will choose to eliminate the y. Since the coefficient here is 1, here is 1 also, right? So 1 is positive, another 1 is negative. I just take the first one plus the second one. The first equation plus the second equation. X plus 2x, you get 3x. Positive y plus negative y, you get 0y, right? The y has been eliminated. 64 plus 5, 69. Okay, so x is equal to 69 divided by 3. X is equal to 23. Okay, next step. Substitute x equal to 23 into, I think I just choose the first one, into the first one. This equation. X plus y. I know x is 23, so I write 23 plus y equal to 64. So y will be equal to 64 minus 23. So this is 1, 41. Oops. Since this is not yet the final answer, I cannot put a sign at this. Okay, now I know x is equal to 23 and y is equal to 41. Next, we go to the final part. What is the difference between these two numbers? So the difference between these two numbers is 41 minus 23. So you get 18. So this is the final answer. 18. Okay, we try one more. The average age of Mrs. Hong and her daughters is 30 years. 30 years. So how to form the equation from this sentence? Average. Now we have two people, right? So we just let the age, let the age of Mrs. Hong be H. 8 years old. And let the age of her daughter. The daughter, okay, D years old. So how to get the average of their age? H plus D divided by 2, you get the average, right? So which is equal to 30. Okay, 2, you times multiply, bring over here, become multiply. So you will get the first equation now. 60. This is the first equation. Okay, second equation. Now, the age of Mrs. Hong is 3 times the age of her daughter. So in how many years time will she be twice as old as her daughter? Okay, never mind. We just solve this part first. We just form an equation for this part first. The age of Mrs. Hong, which is H, is equal to 3 times the age of her daughter equal to 3d. So this is the second equation. So first I have to find the age of Mrs. Hong and the age of her daughter. Means that I need to find the value of h and d. So in this case, I will choose a substitution method. Sub second equation into the first equation. H plus d, and I know h is equal to 3d. Okay, so I write 3d plus d equals 60. 4d equal to 60, and d equal to 60 divided by 4. Okay, now we know a daughter age will be 15. Okay, it's 15 years old. Okay, so how to get the value of h, substitute d equal to 15 into the second equation, h equal to 3d, 3 times 15. Okay, you will get 45. So now you have the h for Mrs. Hong and her daughter. Mrs. Hong is 45 years old and her daughter is 15 years old. After how many years? The question asks you, after how many years will Mrs. Hong age be twice as old as her daughter? Means that this will become double of this. So we don't know after how many years, right? So we just let the number of years be x. After x years, Mrs. Hong age will be 45 plus x. And same thing, after x years, her daughter age will be also plus 5. Okay, now we want this is equal to double, is equal to twice of this. So we form another equation. 45 plus x is equal to 2 times 15 plus x. Okay, now we need to find the x. So the x is the number of years that we are looking for. So this is 45 plus x. Do some expansion here. 30, 2 times 15, you get 30 plus 2x. Okay, so I bring the 30 over here, 45 minus 30. So I just copy 2x minus x. Positive become negative. So this is x, this is 15. Okay, from here, after how many years? So we know after 15 years. After 15 years, Mr. Hong H will be twice as old as her daughter. Okay, so our final answer is 15 years. Okay, so for this video, I just stop here. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.